Well, hello. My name is Mary, and I'm here at the Rockwell Museum. The museum is located in Corning, New York, on the original homeland of the Seneca people. The Seneca are just one of the many Native American tribes living in the United States. Some of the Native American nations you may be learning about are the Crow, the Blackfoot, the Comanche, and the Lakota. And these are just some of the Native American groups living in the Great Plains region of the United States. The Great Plains is located in the center of the country and consists of prairies. And prairies are large, open, expansive spaces full of tall grasses and very few trees. Now, how Native Americans lived long ago and how they live today is very different. And I wanted to share this painting with you by William Robinson Leigh, and it's called The Buffalo Hunt. And Leigh wanted to show us how the Native Americans of the Great Plains hunted the bison or the American buffalo long ago for survival. Now, there are a lot of details in this painting. And when we look closely at a painting, a story begins to unfold. So let's see what story unfolds as we look at the buffalo hunt together. Now, one of the details that I notice first are the hunters. There are several hunters in this painting. How many can you count? Did you count five? Well, let's count them together in case you may have missed one. We have one, two, three, four, and five. If you missed the fourth one, I don't blame you because he's so far in the background, all we can see is his outline, and there's so much dust and dirt flying around in this painting that it makes it even harder to see that hunter in the background. Now, there are so many buffalo in this painting, we're not even going to try to count all of them. But hunting the buffalo was tough work because of their size and because of their strength. Do you know an adult male bison or buffalo can weigh as much as a small compact car? That's pretty heavy, so it was not easy. Now, I want you to imagine with me. Close your eyes and imagine that you're in this place. What sounds do you think you would hear? Why don't you listen for a moment? So if you were in this painting, you would hear your fellow hunters calling to each other. You would hear the thunderous sound of hooves pounding on the dry ground by the horses and the buffalo. And you would hear the horses whinnying and you would hear the bison snorting. It would just be a cacophony of sounds. Now just imagine how you would feel if you were one of these hunters. Now, I think that if I were a hunter, I would be really excited, but really scared all at the same time. In order to be a hunter, you had to be very brave. You had to be very careful so you don't get crushed by one of these large beasts. And you also had to be very good at horseback riding. Now let's look at the weapons that these hunters are using. If we look over at this end, we can see the three hunters have bows and arrows, and then the fifth hunter has a spear. Now how Native Americans hunted in the Great Plains over time changed. Now long ago, before there were horses in the Great Plains, they had to hunt on foot. So large numbers of hunters had to work together and they would surround a buffalo herd and then they would send them stampeding over a cliff or precipice so they would fall to their death. And that was called the buffalo jump. And we can see here the outline of a bison at the bottom of this cliff. But then later on, when horses were introduced, so by the mid-1700s, most of the tribes of the Great Plains had horses, and so they would hunt on horseback, similar to what you see here. So Leigh really, in this painting, is showing us the two different hunting methods that the Great Plains hunters used long ago. Now, the Great Plains has lots of animals to be hunted, but the buffalo was and continues to be the most important animal to the Native Americans of the Great Plains. Because long ago, before there were stores, the buffalo provided just about everything the Plains people needed for survival. It provided their food, clothing, and shelter. And so they had great respect and continue to have great respect for these animals. So you might be thinking, well, how did they use the buffalo? Well, let me share with you some examples of the ways that they used the buffalo. The buffalo provided the Plains people with food. The fresh meat was cooked on a stick or over the fire or boiled to make a stew. The leftover meat was smoked or dried so that it would last a long time. The horns were made into spoons and cups and toys. The bones could be carved into arrowheads, knives, shovels, combs for their hair, and jewelry. Dried manure could be burned for cooking and for heat. And the hides or the skins were used to make clothes, moccasins, a type of Native American shoe, blankets, drums, bags for carrying things, and teepee covers. Teepees were a type of Native American movable home. 12 or more tough skins were sewn together and placed over wooden poles. The teepees had adjustable smoke flaps to help keep heat in or out. The Plains tribes were nomadic. They frequently moved from place to place to follow the herds. The teepees were easy to roll up and pack away for when it was time to travel. So the Native Americans of the Great Plains no longer live in teepees. They live in apartments and houses, and they go to work and they go to school, just as all Americans do. Many Native Americans still use the buffalo in traditional ways for food, and they still hunt the buffalo, and they also make traditional objects, some very similar to what I described to you. And this knowledge has been passed down from generation to generation to keep family and cultural traditions alive, which is so important. The Native Americans of the Great Plains have such a rich culture, and I encourage you to learn more about them. And I hope you will come visit the museum to see this very dramatic painting by William Robinson Leigh called The Buffalo Hunt, and also to see our collection of art and objects made by Native American artists from long ago and as recently as today. Now, if you can't make it to the museum, no worries. On our website, we have our e-museum, and our collection is digitized, and so you can see our art and objects that way. So thank you for joining me, and happy learning.